everyone. So our topic for today is chapter number 4, climate. Now, while talking about climate, see, there are two figures which is given below, figure 4.1 and 4.2. And they are saying that you need to study those maps carefully and then you need to answer the questions which are given below. So the first question is, considering the isotherms of Brazil, what is the average range of temperature in Brazil? Okay, so they are asking you the average temperature. Now if you see the diagram very clearly, you will see the parts in the south. So if you see the part which is in the source, which is in the south, you will see the temperature over there is 28 degrees Celsius, right? And if you see it in the north, upar Brazil likha hai, to B ke upar, you will see there 28. Okay, so the lowest is 18 as per the map given and the highest is 28. Now they are asking what is the average range of temperature in Brazil. So you need to find average of these two. Now I know you might be knowing, right, how to find average. The average is like you need to add 18 plus 28 upon 2. So the value which you get would be the average temperature of Brazil. Fine. Now second question, in which area does it rain more? Now if you see the diagram, figure 4.1, you have been given the scale over there, right? That the scale, like the light itam yellow is the color which has like 500 average rainfall, and then you have the dark blue which is 3000, right? So they are asking which area does it rains more. So all the regions which have dark blue color in it will rain more. Okay, so you can see this dark blue in the northern part of Amazon basins, right? Amazon basin jo upar diya gaya hai wo north part hai barabar. So you can write the north part of Amazon basin, the south part barabar south mein bhi niche hai, and the middle part. So aise you all can answer the questions which have been asked. Okay, so this is called as map reading. When you understand the map, then they ask you particular questions regarding that map and then you have to answer it. Fine, download ne abhi do kiya, baki ke rest of them you try doing it as homework. Okay, if you don't understand, then you can ask me. Coming towards the next page. Now India, the previous map which we saw was of Brazil, right? Hum log ne Brazil ka map dekha. Now we will talk about India. Observe figure 4.3 and write your answers. Which region gets more than 4000 mm of rainfall? Okay, ye 4000 mm se zyada kahan pe barish aata hai. Now if you see the scale which is given there, you will see the dark blue indicates more than 4000. तभी मैप में डार्क ब्लू कलर कहाँ पे है स्टूडेंट, एक तो नॉर्थ में ईस्टर्न पार्ट पे है बराबर, और साउथ में अपना वेस्टर्न पार्ट पे है बराबर ना. नॉर्थ के ईस्ट पार्ट में यू कैन सी द डार्क ब्लू कलर्स एंड साउथ के वेस्टर्न पार्ट में. तो यू विल से दैट नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट एंड साउथ वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया रिसीव्स हेवी रेनफॉल. Right, now they are asking identify the regions with maximum and minimum temperature. So if you see the map carefully, you will see the temperatures are given below, like there are numbers India. So I and D or I ke beech mein dekho 26 likha hai, then 29 hai, 20, 23 hai. So all of these are temperature. So you have to write the maximum and minimum temperature. So what do you think, which one is the minimum and which one is the maximum according to the map? If you read the map carefully, you will see the largest one is 29, right? So 29 kahan pe hai student, sea bay of Bengal ke nazdeek mein hai 29. To wo kaun sa part ho jayega India ka? It would be south eastern part barabar. South to hai barabar hai, par eastern bhi likhne ka क्योंकि ईस्ट साइड है वो. तो साउथ ईस्टर्न पार्ट है 29 बराबर, और दूसरा 29 किधर है? सी, यू कैन सी इट एट द प्लेस ऑफ गुजरात एंड महाराष्ट्र बराबर. तो वहाँ पे 29 है. तो व्हाट यू विल राइट देयर, अगेन देयर बराबर. तो आप गुजरात वाले साइड को कौन सा बोलोगे स्टूडेंट? वेस्टर्न साइड. तो वेयर डू यू फाइंड मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर? 29 इज़ द मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर. और कहाँ कहाँ पे है? साउथ ईस्टर्न पार्ट जो बे ऑफ बंगाल के साइड है और एक गुजरात साइड है विच इज़ वेस्टर्न, बराबर। नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द मिनिमम, मिनिमम कौन सा है, अगर आप लोग ने मैप अच्छे से देखा तो यू विल सी द 20th नंबर विच इज़ गिवन एकदम साउथ में एकदम नीचे, दैट इज़ द मिनिमम। सो वॉट यू कैन से द मिनिमम इज़ इन द साउथ ऑफ इंडिया, ओके। सो दैट इज़ हाउ यू कैन टेल द मैक्सिमम एंड द मिनिमम टेम्परेचर, अंडरस्टूड। इन विच डायरेक्शन इज़ द टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजिंग, तभी कौन से डायरेक्शन में टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज हो रहा है, अगेन सी द मैप केयरफुली, ओके। सो नाउ यू हैव टू रीड द मैप अगेन। तो अगर आप ऊपर, अरे ऊपर भी 20 है, तो हम लोग ने जो पहले वाले क्वेश्चन में देखा दैट वेयर इज़ द मिनिमम टेम्परेचर, तो हम लोग ने साउथ बोला, राइट। एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट एज नॉर्थ हिमालय इज, बिकॉज ऊपर भी 20 है, मैंने 20 ऊपर वाला ध्यान नहीं दिया, ओके। सो मैं देखो मैक्सिमम कहाँ पे था, 29 था, वो कहाँ पे था, साउथ वेस्टर्न एंड सॉरी साउथ ईस्टर्न एंड वेस्टर्न पार्ट, बराबर। एंड मिनिमम कहाँ पे है, साउथ में है और ऊपर नॉर्थ हिमालयस में, बराबर। नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन, आइडेंटिफाई द डायरेक्शन ऑफ विंड शोन, अरे सॉरी, इन विच डायरेक्शन इज़ द टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजिंग। नाउ इफ़ यू सी द डायग्राम केयरफुली, ऊपर 20 है, 26 है, 29 है, so when it is coming downwards it is increasing, right? So you will write that in the direction of south the temperature is increasing. Are you getting it, students? So this is called as reading of map and answering the questions. तो हम लोग ने 3-4 किए answer, the rest of them you understand the map, आप पहले पढ़ो map को, समझो अच्छे से, and then you try finding out the answers, fine? So the rest of them would be your homework. Now coming towards the next part. Next, can you tell, study the graphs given in figure 4.4 and answer the following questions. Okay, so this is again like over here you have to read the graphs. So previously you were reading the map and answering them. Okay, so again let us keep this in homework, because main to kya hai students ke aap logo ko pata chalna chahiye that how to read maps, how to read graphs, what are they telling us, because uske niche exams mein bhi aisa hi hota hai, they just give you graphs, uske niche kuch diya nahi hota, it's on the basis of graph you need to understand what are they trying to tell us, that is why I'm giving you all it as a homework. Now coming towards the next part, geographical explanation, Brazil. Because of the vast latitudinal extent of Brazil, it experiences wide range of climatic variation in climate. For example, near equator it is hot, while temperature type of climate is found near Tropic of Capricorn. Brazil gets rainfall from the southeast trade winds and the northeast trade winds, right? Ke Brazil ka kya problem hai students, that it has a large latitudinal extent, okay, कि उसका जो latitude है वो बहुत ही बड़ा है, and therefore you know there are various climate change which takes place in Brazil. So equator के side we all know the places at the point of equator or at the equator are very hot, and while temperature type of climate and the normal type of climate is found at Tropic of Capricorn. Also, अभी उसको rainfall कहाँ से मिलता है, तो it gets its rainfall from southeast trade winds and the northeast trade winds. So the winds coming from southeast side and north, southeast and northeast sides help Brazil in raining. Parts of the Brazilian highlands extended up to the northern coast. The escarpments act as an obstruction in the wind come from the sea and cause orographic type of rainfall in the coastal region. Orographic rainfall पता है सब लोग को, हम लोग ने किया था ना chapter में, but because of mountains or formations of hills and mountains, वो clouds वहीं पे रुक जाते हैं. And they tend to move upwards. So वहाँ पर जो rainfall होता है that is called as orographic rainfall. Okay, so the areas up to the like the Brazilian highlands extend up to the northern coast. जो Brazilian islands है ना, ये कहाँ तक highlands है ना, mountains है, वो कहाँ तक extend होते हैं, northern coast तक. तो वहाँ पर जितना तक obstruction आता है, till that time you can see orographic type of rainfall. Beyond the highlands, the effect of this winds get reduced. As a result, rainfall is minimum. कहाँ तक rainfall होता है, जब तक उसको वो जो altitude है हमारा या जो highland है, जब तक वो बीच में as an obstruction, it is there at only, you know, till that much time only, it would be like an obstruction for you and therefore rain would fall. But once that place is crossed or once that highland is crossed, nothing can disturb. So therefore the rainfall is very minimal क्योंकि ज़्यादा time वो वहाँ पर obstruct या अटका हुआ नहीं रहता है. This region is a rain shadow region. This region is called drought quadrilateral. Considering the temperature in the Brazil, the northern part of Brazil is hot. Okay, so what are they saying? That therefore the region, as a region, rainfall तो minimal है, वो हम लोग ने देखा. Because जब तक no, it is been obstructed till that particular time only, it will rain. Once it has passed that highland, it won't rain. Okay, so therefore this region is called rain shadow region or drought quadrilateral. Now considering the, you know, according to the temperature of Brazil, the southern part has the northern part of Brazil is hot in temperature and in the southern part are comparatively lower. Okay, so the north part hai, that is very hot, and ye jo south wala hai, ye jo no sorry yeah the south one is a bit low. Seasonal variations are found in this pattern. Near the equator at Brazilian coast, temperature does not vary much. Okay, that when at equator it is always hot. Okay, and temperature does not changes much at that particular time. In the coastal regions near the equator in Brazil, differences in temperature are negligible. The winds moving in the vertical direction in the region. Similarly, the convergence zone of the trade wind is weak here, and as a result cyclones are not formed. That is why tropical cyclones rarely visit the coast of Brazil. Okay, so what are they saying us? That in the equatorial region, okay, there is not much of differences in temperature. Why do you think there is not much of differences? Because equator pe normally kaisa hota hai, the climate is hot and humid only. So there is not much changes. So the winds that are, you know, the winds blow in vertical direction in that region, okay. Similarly, the convergence zone of the trade wind is weak here. So jo convergence zone hai na, that is weak. And that is why cyclones are not much formed there, okay. The cyclones utne form nahi hote because the wind over there, the convergent wind is weak. It is not that strong. And that is why tropical cyclones rarely visit the coast of Brazil. And thus, you know, Brazil mein cyclones or tropical cyclones aane ke chances itne nahi hai. Most of the part of this country lies in the tropical zone. The equator passes through the northern part of the country. The temperature is more in the region. The average temperature in the Amazon Valley is 25 degree to 28 degree Celsius. Okay, so what are they saying? Ke most of the part jo hai na, wo tropical zone ka hai. So jo equator hai na, even that passes to the part of the country which is towards the north. तो वहाँ पे टेम्परेचर कितना है अमेज़ॉन वैली के, वहाँ पे इट इज़ अराउंड समवेयर 25 to 28 डिग्री सेल्सियस. द क्लाइमेट इज कूलर इन द हाईलैंड्स बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रॉक्सिमिटी टू द सी. द ओस्ट एक्सपीरियंस माइल्ड एंड ह्यूमिड क्लाइमेट. द अमेज़ॉन वैली रिसीव्स अराउंड 2000 mm of rainfall, while the northern eastern coast receives 1000 to 1200 mm of rainfall. Okay, so what are they saying? Ke climate jo highlands hai na, jo highlands waha pe climate is a bit cooler, okay, and the like the place which is near to the coastal areas, waha pe bhi also the climate is mild and humid. Why? Because waha pe utna क्या होगा, सुरुरुन सन का इतना आएगा नहीं, एंड दैट इज़ व्हाई इट इज़ माइल्ड एंड ह्यूमिड. बट द अमेज़न वैली रिसीव्स अराउंड 2000 mm ऑफ रेनफॉल. और जो नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट है, बट अमेज़न वैली में रेनफॉल ज़्यादा गिरता है कंपेयर टू द प्लेसेस इन नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट. वहाँ पर इट इज़ लाइक 1000 mm टू 1200. अगेन कैन यू टेल वुड बी योर ये स्टूडेंट्स होमवर्क. इट इज़ जस्ट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड 4.5 ग्राफ्स विच आर गिवन बिलो एंड देन यू नीड टू आंसर देयर क्वेश्चंस. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट ज्योग्राफिकल एक्सप्लेनेशन. इंडिया, इंडियाज क्लाइमेट इज अ मानसून टाइप. द सन रेज आर परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन द ट्रॉपिकल ऑफ कैंसर विच पासिस थ्रू द मिडल ऑफ द कंट्री. And as a result, average temperature are higher throughout the year. Okay. So what happens? The sun rays have, they are perpendicular to the Tropic of Cancer, and which leads to like average temperature. Okay. So यहाँ पे हमारे India में कैसा होता है? That we have average temperature throughout the year. Also, it increases. Also, the temperature increases towards the south. In winter, the temperature drops to -40°C in Jammu and Kashmir and part of mountainous regions of south. Okay, so south mein kaisa hota hai, the temperature keeps on increasing. But while you're talking about north, hum log ko pata hai ki Jammu and Kashmir ho gaya, Manali ho gaya, the places towards the north, they receive like a very, it is like a snowfall area at that particular time, right? So the temperature goes beyond, like it goes to like -40°C. Itna thandi. The diversity in climate conditions of India are due to latitudinal location and altitude of the place. The Indian Ocean and the Himalaya ranges exert a great influence on the climate of India and the origin of monsoon. So hamara kaisa hota hai? Diversity hai, right? We have like hum logo ko kaisa hota hai? We have summers, we have winters, we have rainfall. So we have particularly every season. So that is called as diversity, because most of the places in other countries, it's not the same. Okay, they have like most of the time they have only summers, or most of the time they have only winters. So such is the case of different countries. So compared to them, we are like very well settled. So we have a very diverse climate, which matlab ye kiske wajah se hai diverse? Because of the Indian Ocean and the Himalaya range. Okay, they have a great influence on the climate of our country. Very cold winds blowing from the north are obstructed by the Himalayas. Similarly, on the southwest, monsoon retreats from Shivalik and Himachal ranges of Himalayas. Because of high temperatures in summer, low pressure area develop in Punjab plains and Thar deserts of Rajasthan. This attracts wind coming from the high pressure region in the Indian Ocean, which starts blowing toward the mainland of इंडिया. राइट, कि क्या होता है, सी वेरी कोल्ड विंड्स आर ब्लोइंग इन द नॉर्थ. राइट, कि नॉर्थ में बहुत कोल्ड विंड, एज वी सॉ के -40 पे चला जाता है. सो दैट विंड इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड बाय हिमालयस. सिमिलरली क्या होता है, जो साउथ वेस्टर्न रीजन है उसमें मनसून रिट्रीट होता है. कैसे होता है, इट इज़ थ्रू शिवालिक एंड हिमाचल रेंजेस. ओके, तो उनके वजह से मानसून वहाँ पर टेक प्लेस होता है. Now, because of high temperature in summers mein temperature high hota hai, so low pressure areas developed in Punjab plains and Thar desert of Rajasthan. And we know ki Rajasthan mein garmi ke time pe kitni garmi padti hai, right? So that is because of low pressure area which has been developed because of hot climate. This attract winds coming from the high pressure region in Indian Ocean from the which starts blowing towards the mainland of India. This moisture laden winds bring rainfall. Okay, so yahan se kya hota hai, because of this the winds which are coming they get obstructed. Okay, nahi, they get attracted, and unke wajah se we have like a rainfall occurring. Okay, because of the obstruction caused by the eastern and western Ghat, it rains more in the coastal areas. The rainfall reduces in the leeward side of the hills. This wind blows parallel to the Aravallis, and as a result, rainfall is low in parts of Gujarat and Rajasthan. Why does that happen? Because yahan pe kya hota hai, जो विंड्स आती है ना उनका जो रेनफॉल होता है दैट हैपन्स मोर इन द कोस्टल एरियाज़। ये जो कोस्टल एरियाज़ हैं वहाँ पे उनके वजह से रेनफॉल ज़्यादा होती है, एंड जिसके वजह से जो एरियाज़ है लाइक गुजरात एंड राजस्थान वहाँ पे लो होती है। वाई? बिकॉज इट इज़ पैरेलल टू द अरावलीज। ओके, अगर आप लोग मैप देखोगे तो इट इज़ वेरी पैरेलल, द विंड्स आर वेरी पैरेलल टू अरावलीज, एंड देयरफॉर जो कोस्टल एरियाज़ है ना स्टूडेंट वहाँ पे ज़्यादा बारिश होती है कंपेयर टू गुजरात than Rajasthan. Later, this wind moves towards the Himalayas. Their moisture-carrying capacity increases. Orographic type of rainfall occurs because of the natural obstruction of Himalayas. Right? के वो लोग अभी ऊपर की तरफ जाते हैं, and as they are going ऊपर की side, Himalayas की side, उनका जो moisture-carrying capacity है वो बढ़ जाता है, and that is why it leads to, you know, and they leads to orographic rain, के उनके वजह से orographic rain takes place. This winds return from the Himalaya range and the retreating journey starts. While blowing from northeast towards Indian Ocean, this wind bring rainfall again to some part of peninsula. This is the retreating monsoon season in India. In general, the climate of India is hot throughout the year. Okay, and this when this winds they blow like when they go from northeastern areas towards the Indian Ocean, तो वहाँ पर क्या होता है, they again bring rainfall. Okay, but which places? Peninsular places, and that is why like because of these winds there are monsoon taking place in India. Otherwise we normally have like a normal hot and humid temperature in India. As the Tropic of Cancer passes through the middle of India, India is considered to be a tropical region. Understood? के Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Cancer बीच में से पास होता है, and that is why we have like a tropical region, in India. India faces natural disasters like erratic rainfall, droughts, cyclones, floods, etc. frequently. There are four seasons as per the Indian Meteorological Department, that is the hot weather season, the season of rainfall, the season of retreating monsoon, and the cold weather seasons. Okay, so we normally face certain disasters, like hamare India mein disaster take place hota rehta hai. And which are the four seasons which are given? The hot weather season, the season of rainfall, that is monsoon, the season of retreating monsoon, and the cold weather season. What is them? Let us see further. What is it? We will see further. See, on page number 30, you can see figure 4.7 is dry land and drought affected region. Okay, so the one which is affected by drought and dry land, वैसा हो जाता है, पूरा land ऐसा हो जाता है. Then the second figure is snowfall in India, the beautiful one. The next is rainfall, but this is of Brazil. Then again next one is deforestation, which is of Brazil. And then there is figure 4.11, which shows well, which is like a source of water for Indians, and drought, which is taking place in Brazil. Again there is paddy farming in India, right? Paddy farming hum log karte hai, that is shown. Do you know temperature in Ganganagar in Rajasthan soars to 50 degrees Celsius in June? Just imagine 50 degree, oh my god. Kargil town offer experiences temperature as low as minus 48 degrees Celsius in winter. Mausai and Ram, which is 11,872 mm, and Cherrapunji in East Khasi Hill districts of Meghalaya are the wettest place not only in India but also in the world. Which are they? Mausai and Ram and Cherrapunji. These are like the wettest place. The Jaisalmer in western Rajasthan is the driest part of India. It receives less than 120 mm of rainfall annually. Oh my god, annually. And Tamil Nadu receives maximum rainfall during the retreating monsoon seasons. Let us go to the next page. Ye samjha page students, that were basically the pictures and some information. Coming towards the next part, find out Cherrapunji and Mausai and Ram receives more than 11,000 mm of rainfall. Shillong, located very near to this place, receives only 1,000 mm of rainfall. What could be the reason? नाउ यू फाइंड आउट क्या होगा. अभी हम लोग ने देखा दैट यू नो दैट विंड फ्लोज इन विच डायरेक्शन, एट दैट पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन रेन इज रिसीव्ड अ लॉट और समथिंग लाइक दैट. तो ऐसा टेक्निकल रीजन क्या हो सकता है अकॉर्डिंग टू यू. जस्ट फाइंड आउट स्टूडेंट्स, गिव इट अ ट्राई. Consider the location, extent of Brazil and India. Look for the differences in the elements of climate like temperature and rainfall and write a short note on it. Okay, so you have to consider location. ये Brazil और India को छोड़ के. And then you need to find out, okay, के दोनों countries का temperature में क्या difference है. Yeah, मतलब all the main differences which you see in the two countries. Okay, do you know? Brazil is a tropical country. It normally does not receive snowfall, but in exceptional conditions, southern polar air masses reaches the southern part of air masses. This causes snowfall here. Snowfall has been recorded in 1879, 57 and 85. See, मतलब कभी गिरता ही नहीं है साल में. It's like hardly after 7 to 8 years they have snowfall. Give it a try. In which part of India are the three crops grown in a year? And how is this relatable to rainfall over there? So which are the crops which are growing in India and unka rain se kya connection hai? How are they related to it? You need to find out. Okay, so I hope you have understood the chapter. Main to kaisa hai students ki aapko wo jo starting mein map reading tha ya fir graph diagram tha usko read karna aana chahiye, because exam mein they just give you maps, right, and information related to it. You need to find out the questions, you need to apply your brains. So make sure that wo wala part aapka acche se hua hai, fine. And again, the climate chapter was very easy. You got to know what is about, you know, what are the things which are related to Brazil compared to India. So yeah, I hope the chapter is very well understood to you. Again, the exercise questions would be your homework, because I always believe that if the chapter is very well understood, the concepts are clear, then exercise question is something you all can try by yourself. So yeah guys, that was it for today's session. We'll see you all in the next one. Till then, bye bye and take care. Bye.